Howdy, everyone. It's the Repairman here. Welcome to another beautiful evening here at good old Arkham Sanitarium. I hope you're doing well. The professor had asked me if I could perform some routine maintenance on his computer. So I thought it would make for an interesting moment to show you what the insides of a computer looks like, how to safely clean one, remove some of the components, and of course give you the specs on the professor's current system. So I took a little time away from all the droids and synthetics and synths that I'm usually working on, and folks like yourself, the professor and his brother also work on. Yeah, nice modifications there, by the way. Are those tentacles? Yeah. Anyway. So, well, you can just sit right on back, relax, get comfortable, and I'm just going to get started here. So, it's going to be a few things that we're going to need to clean this machine out. It's the professor's personal computer, not one of the many mainframes that keep the sanitarium operational, not to mention the rift. But anyway, we're not going to get into all that. Maybe one day we'll take a tour. It's a top secret part of the facility. But anyway, oh yeah, there's one more thing. Need to get your name, if you'd be so kind, or your room number. Okay. And would you mind just signing this? There you go. It's just an NDA that, thank you, to make sure that anything you see here I tell you about can't be disclosed to anyone else, to any of the other patients, to the public, FBI, CIA, any number of government or factions that exist in any universe. Okay, otherwise, well, let's not talk about otherwise. Okay, thank you. All right, so how about the tools? Tools that we'll need to clean this machine up. Well, first I got this 2-inch brush. I actually lost mine, so I had to borrow one from that new resident painter, Rob Ross. I'm not sure if you're familiar with him. Professor brought him in. Said he was recently back to life. So, still getting adjusted, acclimated to life after death, so to speak. Tell you, it's a reanimation. The professor picked up from his former colleague. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing of science. So, using that to brush off some of the bigger overall parts and whatnot. And for some of the parts that we can't reach, some of the smaller spaces, we're going to use this half-inch brush. Yeah, so using that. We'll also be using this Phillips screwdriver. Star screwdriver, however you want to call it. Most of the PC's components, most PC components are affixed with a screw that's going to require star-shaped or Phillips screwdriver, not flathead. So, using that. And we'll also be using some canned air. We're going to use this first to blast away most of the dust. And then what we'll do after that is just use the brushes to get rid of the dust that the compressed gas duster didn't get rid of or couldn't loosen up. Alright, so that's what we got so far. Also going to be using this, you're going to need a cloth, a damp cloth, not a wet one. A damp cloth, just to wipe up some of the dust. I wouldn't necessarily recommend wiping any of the exposed electronics and chipsets and things like that, but most of the other areas should be all right. Now, you can use anything. This is just a t-shirt that I borrowed from my good buddy, Meatball Jeff. Yeah. You can always find him down at the lounge watching the sports. He's got an obsession with the sports. Never seen anything like it. You should see his room. Sports paraphernalia everywhere. It's all he talks about. Anyway. So you need a little damp cloth. Alright. Last thing we're going to need is a bottle of Virgil's root beer. Now, this isn't for cleaning. This is for drinking. Specifically, to keep my motor running. Believe it or not, this is a very labor-intensive job. It's probably going to require about 5 hours of manual labor. At least that's how much I'm going to bill the professor for. Even though it's probably going to take me half an hour here, maybe 45 minutes to show you. Do you like that? It's a rather nice sound, isn't it? Sometimes I go over there to Dr. Clemmons, you know, the beak. And I'll go in there and I'll say, oh, you know, I'm all stressed out from the job, and I'll perform one of those sessions for me, one of those AMRS sessions. All right. This we're going to put back here because I don't want it too close to the components. All right, now. Let me just move some of the stuff out of the way that I'm not going to use right away. Now, we talk about the specifications of this here computer. Okay. So, have you ever seen the inside of a computer before? Okay. A lot of people don't quite understand or have never seen the insides of a computer before. And that's quite all right. Not everybody is into computers or needs to know how they work. They just want a computer that runs so they can get their job done. Okay. Well, all these components is what it takes for you or anyone to do some word processing, play some video games, go on the social media, whatever the facility allows here, and whatever bandwidth you're allotted. But so what we got here, I'm going to go through the computer specs, professor's computer specs. All right, we're going to start with the motherboard. The motherboard is like the central nervous system. Okay. Just like your central nervous system. Let's say an average human nervous system. Spinal column, you know, the brain, right? The arms plug into the spinal column, the legs, the heart, the eyes, and things like this. Well, here you have the heart, power supply unit. Here you have the eyes, the video card. Here you have, in behind here is a fan, the CPU. Yeah, you could consider that like the brain. And here, now we have the hard drives. It's like the memory where you store all your information, your documents, your programs, just like the synapses and cells and all that inside the human brain. You have up here memory, the RAM. That's how you could say. I'm not really sure how to, the analogy that's best for that, but the more RAM you have, the more you're able, the more programs, more tasks you're able to do, the quicker things you're able to perform, and things like that. Okay. So, the motherboard, everything is plugged in. You see here ASRock. Right, this all, this black here, big rectangular component. That's the motherboard. Alright, that's where everything plugs into. Like I said, like the central nervous system. Alright, this particular motherboard is an ASRock Z97 Extreme 4 with an Intel chipset. Okay. These here are aluminum alloy heat sinks. What these do is they absorb the heat from the motherboard and all the MOSFETs and chipsets so that it helps to keep a little cooler. It absorbs the heat. The heat sinks into these little parallel little grid type things. Sometimes the heat sinks come in all different types and shapes, but I've never really looked underneath what those look like, but that's what those blue things are. That motherboard has a lot of other nice features. I'm not going to get into the specifics of it, but that is the motherboard. Most every computer needs one and has one. Alright. Now here, behind here actually, this is the, it's a fan. Underneath the fan is the CPU. Okay, that's like the brain. Very important part. All these parts you need to run, but without the brain, forget it. Well, without the heart, you know. But the brain, very important. This particular CPU is a Haswell Intel quad-core i5-4690K. It is not overclocked. This current setup, the professor is able to perform all the tasks that he needs to do to help run the facility. And of course, to play some of the latest video games. The professor does have a little bit of a gaming addiction. Just remember the NDA. Okay. Anyway, so that's underneath here. I'm not going to take the CPU cooling fan apart to show you that underneath there. You could easily Google that. I'm not sure if they allow Google access here in the sanitarium. There was that one time. Anyway, but yeah, so that keeps the CPU cool, doesn't overheat, especially if you're overclocking it. Overclocking it means you're making the CPU run faster than it normally would. Okay. Now, let me get into the next thing, and I'll talk about the case. The RAM, right here we have. 8 gigs of a dual DDR3 Crucial Technology RAM. Okay, I believe it's 4 and 4. I don't think it's 8 and 8. I think it's 8 gigs total. Pardon me. I'm just gonna grab myself a drink. I'm a little bit parched. I hope that life is treating you well. I know it's kind of a strange thing to say in here in the middle of this, but you know, one thing I learned here at the sanitarium is compassion, you know, and empathy. I mean, I've always had those traits. You know, I came here to do a job. but after a while, seen a lot of the folks, the professor and Nurse Manley and Dr. Corvus and sweet, sweet Margaret, and so many others, Dr. Sheldon, Dr. Frank, all the patients they've been dealing with, and, well, I can't but help to, you know, that kind of compassion and empathy starts to come out a little bit more. It's contagious. All right, anyway. Okay. Where was I? Yeah, the RAM. Thank you. Okay, now the last part. The GPU, the graphics processing unit. I think that's what it stands for anyway. That's right here, this big puppy. This is a EVGA GeForce GTX 770 classified top secret. Okay. And this is the eyes. Well, the monitor is really like, I guess, the eyeballs, maybe. But, yeah, in any case, this is the eyes of the computer. It lets you see everything that the computer is generating for you. Okay? Plug your monitor into this. Alright. So those are the four key components. Everything else outside of that is pretty generic. Down in here, two hard drives, a C drive and a D drive. Don't ask me offhand, but I don't think they are the latest and greatest in hardware, hard drive technology. SATA drives, I believe, but in any case. Here we have the Corsair CX750. I believe that's an M behind here. 750 watts now, based on the power that all these components require, you're going to need a powerful PSU, power supply unit. $750 may be a little too much, but I believe the professor needed something more than just $500 or $550. So he opted to go with this. Might give him a little bit more headroom than he might need, but better to be safe than sorry. Okay. So this supplies power to everything. Graphics card, hard drives, CD-ROM up here, motherboard, fans, everything requires power, almost everything. Some things plug in, don't necessarily require direct power, can take power from the motherboard itself. All right, now, your typical case. Computer cases come in all shapes and sizes. And the layouts are all different. This is an Antec 900 case. Professor, I believe, built his first computer back, it wasn't long after the, this one, say it's about almost 10 years old, this case. Much more than what the professor needs, but again, better to be safe than sorry. It's strong. It's about 50 pounds. Quite heavy. It has a top fan up here. intake fan pulls air in right over the motherboard. So we have this fan here on top of the CPU pulling in air from here. So you got air flowing right here. You have this fan, I believe that's an exhaust fan, pulling out hot air. So as things get hot in here, this fan draws in cool air from the outside. That cool air passes right around here, goes out that way, and goes into the cascades over the CPU with that fan. There's another fan down here, which I believe pulls from the front to the back and keeps the power supply unit cool. I believe the power supply unit has its own fan as well. Okay. Up here, these right here are hard drive bays. Hard drives down here. You probably could put some hard drives up here, but Professor has a CD-ROM drive up there. What else do we have? I think there was another drive bay here, but it might have been taken out, yeah, to make room for cables. Right here, this little card, we'll take that out. That's an IEEE card. It's for older devices. Motherboards used to have IEEE ports built in, but the devices that use them are becoming dinosaurs, so to speak. All right. And so this is a typical case. You need fans to help cool all the insides. Let me swing this case around here for you. This is the back of the computer, of the case. Power switch. Turn the computer on. Well, actually, no. Turn the power supply unit on. This needs to be on in order for the computer to turn on. All right, this is the main power cord for the power supply unit. These here are different slots. You can see the Professor has taken some of the slot guards, you might call them, which doesn't really matter too much, but if there's any other components that the Professor might like, put them in here. Here's the graphics card. Has quite a few ports for a monitor, HDMI, DVI-D, another DVI-D. I believe this can run two monitors, dual monitors, something like that. Professor only needs one. Here's the IEEE ports. This is for the Professor to use his old camcorder. Some highly classified videos and such are often used with that. Old session recordings and things like this. Here's the fan, of course. And here's all those slots that your devices get plugged into, like your mouse and your keyboard. These are the USB slots. These are the little ports for the microphone, headphone. You might have some HDMI slots, some old keyboard ports. These are just the switches for the fans. They can run on low, medium, or high. Okay. So that's all of these ports are actually part of the motherboard. All right. So. All right. So, I hope that helps give you a basic understanding of the inside of the professor's computer and computers overall, what it takes for them to run. So next, I'm going to start taking apart the components, let you see them up close, you know, at least outside of the where they're plugged into, and we'll start cleaning this thing. Then we'll put it all back together, and then that'll do it. All right. So I'm going to start with, just in case you didn't know or think about it, before you try to do this yourself, make sure everything's unplugged, the monitor, the power cord especially. Make sure you have your shoes on, and make sure you do it in a location in a manner that there's not going to be any static electricity. Last thing you want to do is generate static electricity working in your socks on a rug, touch something here and cause something to short out. Now they do sell wristbands that you can keep you grounded while you work, but I'm pretty grounded myself here with my setup, so no worries. Okay. Alright, that IEE port card, actually doesn't have a that doesn't have a screw, so all right. So this is a IEE card. Show you that close up. All right. So I'm not really sure if you've ever seen a computer component close up. Alright, this is StarTech. Name of the company. Fairly inexpensive. Competitively priced. All that little different. Parts, don't even ask me to begin to explain, because I'm not that kind of an expert. And there's the ports. Alright. Alright. Now, I'm going to give this a nice little brush. And that's all you want to do. Is just brush that dust off in case there's any dust on it. And brush some of it off there. I'm going to actually blast all these with that canned air in here in a minute. Take out the graphics card. Oh, before I take that out, this particular graphics card requires power from the power supply unit, so we're going to remove those first. Cables. The reason for that is because this happens to be a gaming graphics card. The professor says it can play everything at the highest maximum. This particular build, he built this about 2 years ago, if I recall correctly, the very first computer that he built. Very first computer he built with this case about 10 years ago. And was it just a dual? Wasn't a quad core. I think it was a dual core. I can't really remember the speed of it. Just take a peek. Screw it out of there. Alright, there's a little tab we have to press here. And then we just... looks like it... There we go. A little awkward to do it this way, showing you. Just take our time. That's a pretty big graphics card. You can see that all right. It's got two fans on it. Not sure what these are here. It's possible that these are heat sinks. Help cool, help absorb the heat. So as they absorb the heat, fans cool them down, and the cycle just repeats. So, yeah. I believe that may be the case. And in the back we have all the those parts there. And all graphics cards come in different shapes and sizes. All the ports right here. All right, so we're gonna give that a nice little clean. And all we're going to do, take your canned air, never shake it. Always keep it vertical. You can keep it about 2 inches away. And let's just get rid of that. Top tab there. All right. This is fairly clean. Professor did clean it not too long ago. It's not too important to clean the insides of a computer, but it's a good idea to every so often, because dust can build up and it could potentially cause issues, though it's very rare, so it's nothing to get, you know, to obsess or get paranoid over and worry about. Take our 2-inch brush. Just get rid of any of the dust. at the canned air, couldn't get rid of. The fans are fairly clean, but usually the edges of the fan blades will accumulate dust. All right, and just do is we'll brush the ports a little bit, just like that. There we go. Set this aside. Best I remove my root beer. Last thing I need is to spill. The professor would have my head. Literally. All right. Let's get rid of the RAM. Not rid of it, but let's take it out of here. Pop that one open. Like I said, it's a little awkward working this way. So I'm just gonna do our best right here. And there we have the 2 8 gigs. 4 gigabytes each, I believe, the Crucial Ballistics DDR3 RAM, 1600 megahertz, 99924. I know that's a little bit important for some folks, but it's a little bit beyond the repair man. All right, don't really need to spray these down. Pretty clean. All right. That's pretty much it. We're just going to spray this down and spray down the whole case while we're at it. Then we'll go through and brush the components up. Let's get rid of all the major dust buildup first with this. You can see it's pretty dust-free. Like I said, I already performed some maintenance not long ago on it. Might be able to see some of this dust flowing around. I think that should do it for the canned air. I was going to go through here and it's our big brush, 2-inch brush. And give this a nice brushing right here. Just like that. brush there. It's gonna be hard to brush that one. Get to that a little bit. All right, that's pretty good. It doesn't have to be perfect. You don't have to get everything real nice and shiny. The whole idea is just to get rid of a lot of the major dust buildup. All right, let's take our half-inch brush here. What do you say we start at the top here? Get in here with the CPU fan, just like that. All the exhaust fans, try to clean the dust out of there. There we go. Just like that. Don't overdo. Don't overdo. There we go. Without being perfect, you just want to get rid of a lot of major dust buildup. There we go. You could do the ports as well if you wanted to, but as long as you get the major components taken care of, all around the fans, and maybe exposed ports. And you should be good to go. Just like we are here. I think that's going to do it. Take our little damp cloth here. I don't know why this one has that blood on it. What the heck Meatball Jeff has been up to? That's my pencil. I wonder why he was easy, so willing to part with this. What's that stain on here? Cheese curls. All right, and just get in here and just wipe up standing dust. A nice wipe there. Just like that. Let's get some of these tools out of my way. Some of these components. Let's get in here and just wipe nice and gentle. Like, don't overdo. Don't overdo. There we go. Just a nice wipe. Just like that. All right. Okay. You don't really want to touch the main components with the rag. You don't want to leave any fibers in any of the ports or anything like that, just in case. Get it wet. All right. There we go. Nice. That's gonna do it. Let's put our beast of a graphics card back in here. Try to do this as nice and gentle like as possible. Should just pop right back in. There we go. Excuse my reach there. That's one screw. Every time I say that word screw, it reminds me of a scene from The Breakfast Club. You familiar with that movie, The Breakfast Club? The principal, is it Vernon? Principal Vernon, I think. You got, I can't remember all their names. It's been a long time, but, he comes in there. Is it Bender? Bender, I forget his name. Takes a screw out of the door. Vern comes in and wants to try to steal the. He wants to know who stole the screw. And Bender, he says, smart like, he says, "Excuse me, sir, why would anyone want to steal a screw?" So many great lines from that movie. All right, let's get this here. IEE card. It's trying to be difficult. There we go. Let's get the RAM back in. And that should. Pop into place. So I get. There we go. And that, my friend, is the professor's computer, and is how you clean a computer. And is all the components that makes up a computer. Every computer is different. Some people overclock their computers and have them running at all kinds of crazy speeds, but they have coolers in there, water cooling things and all this. There you have it. Hope you found this a little interesting. Maybe a little entertaining. While you're there watching from your room. Unless you're down at the one of the at the atrium. Or even the lounge. That is, if Jeff will even let anyone watch anything else in there besides sports. But I gotta go. I got an R2 unit that's been acting up. Gotta go check it out. Thank you for joining me. I wish you all my best, and you take care of yourself, and hopefully we'll see you again real soon. Bye-bye now. Okay. CPU. Check RAM, check motherboard, GPU, cleaned, performed, routine maintenance, system, diagnostics not performed.